Good morning, dear students. Today our topic is left ventricle, its external surface and the interior. Okay, so see, this part is left ventricle. Why this part is left ventricle? Because you can see here, this is the anterior interventricular groove. It separates left ventricle from the right ventricle. So by the presence of anterior interventricular groove, you can separate left ventricle from the right ventricle. Now we will see which part of the heart is contributed by the left ventricle. Left ventricle contributes the apex. So apex is formed by only by the left ventricle. Now it also contributes the sternocostal surface, 1/3 of the sternocostal surface, whole of the left surface, 2/3 of the diaphragmatic surface is contributed by the left ventricle. What are the borders contributed by left ventricle? That is, first one is the left border. It is contributed by the left ventricle. So left border. Next is a little part of the inferior border near the apex, and the left half of the anterior part of the atrioventricular groove. So by this atrioventricular groove, the left ventricle is separated from the left atrium and left auricle. See, this is the left auricle. Posteriorly, left ventricle is separated from the left atrium by the posterior part of the atrioventricular groove. Now we will come to the internal features. Left ventricle is separated from the right ventricle by presence of the interventricular septum. Interventricular septum attached anteriorly to the interventricular groove and posteriorly to the posterior interventricular groove. Okay. And this interventricular septum bulges more to the right side. That's why on cross section, the right ventricle is of semilunar in shape. It is of semilunar in shape. And left ventricle, that is circular in shape. That is, you can't appreciate from here. This is a cross section. Now we will go to the interior of the left ventricle. See, this is the interior of the left ventricle. The interior of the left ventricle, we can see the musculature. The musculature of the left ventricle is 3 times more thicker than the right ventricle. See, this is the wall of the right ventricle. This is so much thin here, but compare it with the wall of the left ventricle. That is 3 times thicker than the right ventricle. Why? Because left ventricle has to pump blood against the systemic circulation. Okay, it has to pump blood in the systemic circulation against the pressure of the aorta. So that is much more higher. On the contrary, right ventricle has to pump the blood into the pulmonary trunk against the pulmonary pressure. So it is much more lower than the systemic pressure. Next, you know, right, like right ventricle, left ventricle again consists of one inflow part, that is the rough part, and one outflow tract, that is the smooth part. So here we can see, this is the inflowing part, that is the rough part. This is the inflowing rough part of the left ventricle. So this part consists of one valve, that is the mitral valve. You can see here one cusp, mitral valve. Mitral valve, that is attached to the mitral annulus, and that is a bicuspid valve. and you can see here one cusps of the mitral valve. And what are the other structures? So here also the ridges, bridges and the papillary muscle. So you can see this is one papillary muscle. This is one papillary muscle, and here is the another papillary muscle. And to the apex of the papillary muscle, you can appreciate there is attachment of this very thin thread-like structure, that is the endothelial lined collagenous structure called cordytendine. So this cordytendine attached to the apical part of the papillary muscle, and on the other side it is attached to the free margin of the valve cusp. So this is the cordytendine, and these two are the papillary muscle. One is anterior and one is posterior papillary muscle. So this is about the inflow rough part of the left ventricle. Now coming to the smooth outflow part. So smooth outflow part, it is formed by the aortic vestibule. Okay, aortic vestibule, and there is origin of the ascending aorta, and there is aortic orifice and aortic semilunar aortic valve. So you can see this is the ascending aorta. This vessel is the ascending aorta with its three branches: brachiocephalic trunk, left common carotid, left subclavian. So this is the cut portion of the ascending aorta. Here we can see, if you see this part, this is the aortic valve. So this is the aortic valve cusp. You can see these three valve cusps, semilunar valve cusp. These are the aortic valve cusp. Now above this valve cusp, you can see here one dilatation, that is the sinus, aortic sinus. Above the valve cusp there is dilatation, that is the aortic sinus. And from this aortic sinus, there is origin of the two coronary artery. There is one aortic sinus, one valve cusp, and posteriorly two cusp. So one anterior aortic sinus and two posterior aortic sinus, one right and one left. From the anterior aortic sinus, you know there is origin of the right coronary artery. So this dilatation. And posteriorly, on the right side, this is non-coronary sinus, as from there no coronary artery arises. And on the left side, from the left posterior aortic sinus, there is the origin of the left coronary artery. Right? So a little bit of development, that is the inflowing rough part of the left ventricle. It is developed from the primitive ventricle. And the smooth part, that is the aortic vestibule, that is developed from the conus arteriosus.